Hi there, I'm Susan Riley from educationcloset.com. I'm so glad you're here learning more about arts integration. You know, there's a lot of myths out there about arts integration, and this area, we're going to dispel those myths and talk to you about the facts. So what is arts integration? Arts integration is an approach to teaching and learning through which content and art standards are taught and assessed equitably. So what does that mean and what does it look like? Well, in arts integration, there is a simple four-step process. So you pick the topic or the idea that you want to focus on. You collaborate with other educators. So if you're a classroom teacher, you will be collaborating with arts educators. And if you're an arts educator, you will collaborate with a classroom teacher. And the reason that you're collaborating is to find those naturally aligned standards. We call that an elegant fit. Standards that make sense and go together across content areas. Once you find those standards and you've paired them together in reference to your topic or idea, then you can go ahead and create an arts integrated lesson. From there, you teach that lesson with your students, and then you finally assess that lesson with them. Four simple steps. Now, while they sound simple, we teachers know there's a whole lot more that goes into it than that. And that is what this site is here for. In this site, you're going to find sample arts integration lessons that you can print out and use in your own classroom. Give it a try. You'll find easy tips and resources, downloads to help you make this process easier. You'll find arts strategies where we walk you through how to do that so that you feel empowered to bring it to your own classroom and like you can give this a try with your students. We also offer a fully developed curriculum for arts integration and STEAM. We offer an online conference twice a year so that you can get those best practices and see what's working in other classrooms. We offer some online classes, so if you want to dive deeper into the process and really get to know it so that you can go ahead and use it in your classroom, we have that available for you as well. Lots of resources here on this site to help make this process easier. Now, I do want to take a minute to dispel some of those myths that are hanging around out there about arts integration. The first one is, does arts integration replace arts education? And the answer is absolutely not. So arts integration is a natural next step for arts education. In order to have the most robust and best practiced arts integration approach, you need to have a dedicated arts program. And here's why. In order to use arts integration most effectively, your students need to have the skills and processes under their belts. They have to know those explicit skills and processes in both content areas that you're trying to integrate. So if you're trying to integrate visual art and math, those students need to have the skills and processes in both the visual art area and the math area. So you have to have direct instruction in each of those content areas in order for the integration to work. The integration happens as a natural next step after students have had that direct instruction. Now, what that means is that you can't have arts integration replacing arts education. Because if students don't have those skills, if they've not learned those skills in an art class or a music class, then they're not going to be able to integrate with them. So, no, it doesn't replace. It simply makes that learning more meaningful for your students. So also in this approach, the content and art standards are naturally aligned, taught, and assessed equitably. So what that means is that this is different than arts enhancement. Arts enhancement is when you do a great, visual art project on top of something that you're already doing in maybe your math or your ELA classroom. So for instance, maybe making a shadow box to show the planets after learning about those planets in the science room. That would be arts enhancement. Or learning 50 nifty United States as a song to help you memorize the names of the states in the United States. That is arts enhancement. Arts integration is when you're intentionally looking for those natural alignments. So if you're doing a lesson on fractions in math and you pair that with a lesson on note values in music, and you look for those natural alignments, you identify those standards, then you teach both simultaneously and you assess both. So the assessment, students have to do an assessment that demonstrates that they understand note values and the fraction part. So they have to be able to do both. So that's what we're talking about when it comes to arts integration. It's the next level. So keep that in mind when you're thinking about arts integration. It's much more about the intention of how you're using it and being thoughtful of that intention. You also want to make sure that the content area that you are pairing is not being used in service of your content area. So here's what I mean by that. If you are pairing a visual art standard with your science standard, you're not using the visual art in service of the science that you're teaching. Okay, so you're not having students draw or sketch just because that brings in visual art into your classroom. That's making the art in service of the science. Or vice versa, if you are in a music classroom, you're not bringing in reading just as a beginning warm-up. That's using the reading in service of what else you have going on in that classroom. Instead, you're really looking to pair them equitably, pull them both together so that when you're doing this lesson, it's almost like you can't tell if you're in an English language arts class or a music class or a dance class or a math class, that it really pairs together beautifully and works in tandem. I've also talked about the fact that students need to have explicit instruction in the arts in order to make this work, but I want to bring that point really close to home for you. This does not replace your arts education program. Please keep that in mind. Your students need to have that valuable instruction in order to use arts integration effectively. Also, keep in mind that collaborative planning should be dedicated time between your content area teachers and your arts area teachers. And yes, I know that that is a challenge, especially with scheduling. Do be sure to check out our planning tools area on this site so that you have some ideas on how to make that a reality with your various schedules. But collaborative planning is incredibly important because both teachers need to be at the table in order for integration to happen. Also, last thing I want you to keep in mind, professional development in arts integration is a must if you're going to use this approach. So that's what this entire site is here to help you do, provide you with professional development, whether it's through our daily magazine, our classes, our conferences, or even our curriculum. All of those items are designed to provide teachers with professional development. You cannot expect teachers to do this without some sort of a basic understanding of how to use arts integration and what it is and how it works in the classroom setting or in an arts classroom setting. You have to have professional development. So please be sure to set aside funds and time for that if you're serious about using this approach in your school or your classroom. And as always, we are here to help you with that. Thanks so much. Please feel free to enjoy the rest of this page where we go into detail about these elements about arts integration, and be sure to keep us in your bookmark list so that you can keep coming back because we always have new ideas, resources, downloads, and more to share with you.